Hey guys, welcome back. This is Bernard for the BTNHD and the top 10 things to speed up that slow PC in 2019. So let's get started. Top number one in my list is hungry resources. You're going to do a Control Alt Delete and go to Task Manager or Shift Control Exit or right click on the taskbar and go to Task Manager. And you want to go inside Processes, click on the Memory or the CPU column and organize it. So to the point that you are able to see which one is the highest. For this example, my antiware, which is Windows Defender, was pretty high and taking a lot of the resources. So that's not something that I want to kill, but if you have something else that's taking a lot of resources, just right click on it and just end the task. Number two on my list is system tray. Now this is a really bad example because I keep my stuff pretty clean, but if you have like Creative Cloud, you have a bunch of other stuff like tools like Snagit, OBS running within your system tray. That stuff is actually running behind the scenes and taking resources from your PC. So close that stuff up if you're not using it. Top number three, startup programs. Believe it or not, if you have like Skype or Windows Defender and other tools, they automatically start up when you start your machine, right? When you log it into your desktop, stuff is still happening behind the scenes, and most likely there are applications. To get into this, just go inside Task Manager, go to Startup, right-click on it, and disable it. Okay. Now, top number four on my list is Reduce Animation. Now, Windows 10 is really heavy with the animation thing, so to remove it is pretty easy. You want to right-click on the Start menu, go to System. Within System, go to System Info. Within System Info, you want to go inside Advanced System Settings. And you want to locate the performance, click on settings, and by default, it's set as let Windows choose what's the best for your computer. You don't really want that. So what you want to do is adjust the best performance. When you pick adjust for the best performance, it's going to uncheck all this stuff here, which is what you want. And just apply it, okay, and you should be good to go. Top number five is browser cleanup. Yes, your browser. If you're a person like me that uses Chrome, I like to use extensions, not a lot of them, but if you click on the three little dots, go to More Tools, and you go inside Extensions, you should see like a bunch of plugins and extensions with Chrome if you're using that. If you're using Firefox or Internet Explorer, again, just clean up those extensions and plugins. If you're not using them, they're behind the scenes using resources, and you should just remove them if you're not using them or disable them. Top number six on my list is scan the computer. So within Windows 10, click on the Notification Center, go to All Settings, click on Update and Security, go to Windows Security, open your Windows Security, and just click on Virus Threat and Protection, and just do a quick scan. Now within Windows 10, Windows Defender automatically does this, and it also keeps the definitions within your Windows Defender up to date, so you don't really need to worry about that. Top number 7 on my list is disk cleanup. So if you go inside the Start menu and start typing disk cleanup and click on the disk cleanup app, it gives you a nice little summary of what you can clean up and free up within your C drive. If you click on clean up system files, it will go a little deeper inside your C drive and locate files like the Windows updates that can be removed. And this size right here will get a little higher if you do clean up your Windows updates. Top number 8 in my list is defrag the hard drive. Pretty easy. You go inside the Start menu and start typing defragment and just click on the defragment and optimize drives, and you get the nice little wizard here. You can pick the C drive, which is your primary hard drive. This is where the Windows operating system is installed, and this is the one that you should optimize. Now, top number 9 on my list is unwanted software. Remove them, right? Click on Start, start typing Control Panel, and within Control Panel, go inside Programs and Features, and within Programs and Features, you're going to get a whole list of all the software that is installed in your machine. If you're not using a particular software and it's using a lot of space within your machine, remove it. It's junk. It's just there. It's being used behind the scenes regardless if you're not using it. Just throw it away, remove it, clean it up. And top number 10 on my list is like if top 1 through 9 does not work out for you, number 10 should work, and that's the reset. If you click on the notification icon and go to All Settings, within All Settings, go to Update and Security. Within Updates and Security, you want to go inside Recovery. Within Recovery, you're going to locate Reset This PC. Click on Get Started, and you have two options here. It keeps all your files, removes apps and settings, but keeps your personal files. or removes everything and just completely wipes it and reinstall the operating system. Now, if you're doing this, make sure you back up everything. Make sure that you have every CD or every download EXE file to download the applications again. You have full backups of your Word documents or your photos or whatever, so you can re-download them, reinstall them into the machine. If 1 through 10 does not work out, that means you need a new machine. Well, don't automatically go out and purchase a machine. Upgrade the memory. Or if you're running a SATA hard drive, most likely you could purchase a solid state drive, which is extremely fast read and write speeds. But if you purchase a new solid state drive, that means you got to get yourself a copy of Windows 10 and reinstall it inside that hard drive. I think the first thing that you could do, which is the easiest, is upgrade the memory, because you could open up the box and just plug and play within the DIMM slots and you're good to go and see if that works out. If the memory does not work out, hard drive. If the hard drive and the memory doesn't work out, and you're probably using an old processor, then it's time for you to start thinking about getting a new machine. So hopefully you guys enjoy this top 10 tips. Leave comments right below. Don't forget about hitting that like button, and I catch you guys on the next one. Peace out.